Everybody, this is Praxis. I'm here up on the top level. My dad's here helping today. Josh is here and River's here today. Josh has been spending most of the day today going along all these floor joists on the lower level and putting some 16D nails. Those are pretty big nails in from the sides we didn't nail through to kind of get all the floor joists just really nice and squeezed up tightly together. So that's what he's been doing most of the day today. My dad and I have been up here. My dad's been finishing out these posts. You can see on this side, they're just a single vertical 2x4 is coming up. But to put up these trusses, and you can see one of them to your left right here, to put them up, they have to rest on the two side 2x4s that you can see off to the side here. So my dad's been getting those all cut and set to length. Putting this up was pretty crazy. You know, I kind of wish I had ran video during it. There was some real drama during it. I was pretty nervous as we were putting it up, the idea that it's going to go over. But we had a safety strap you can see behind you and some other boards connected to it. As it turned out, it worked out, fine. I feel like there was some luck involved in that, and I don't tend to be a big fan of luck. Maybe not, but I felt a little nervous during it. But anyway, the first one's up, and that's great because now all the other ones have that to lean against if, they start, falling over when we're putting them up. But I don't even think that'll be likely because as we're putting them up, you can get to either side of them. For the first one, we could only be on one side, so we couldn't run to the other side if it started to fall over. But before I put them together, one thing I've been doing to help me while I put the sheathing board on the top is all tongue and groove. Same way the walls are tongue and groove, it's going to be tongue and groove going up the top. Before I put them together, what I've been doing is marking kind of a ruler on the top of these guys. And that is so while we're putting up the sheathing boards, we'll be able to kind of easily gauge without having to constantly pull out a tape measure and measure from the peak down or from the bottom up to see if whether one side of the boards is getting ahead of the other side of the boards, because you want them to kind of start at the same level and end at the same level so you don't have like crooked boards by the time you get to the top. So what I've done with these are a set of the trusses that or the truss boards that are yet to be put together. I've taken a tape measure and I've run a measure along it. I've put marks at each foot, 1 foot, 2 foot, 3 foot, 4, 5, 6. It goes up to 13 feet. And what I'm going to do now is just scribe the line across 5 of these. I've got to do 10 altogether, but I'm just doing them 5 at a time. And what this is doing is making it so, like I said, I have that ruler. And of course, on each one of these, I have to put the foot number. So I put 1 on all these, 2, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3. And I'm just going to go along the length of it. From the past, I know when doing the decking or anything like that, it's really handy if when you have them all down like this, you can just mark them up here instead of having to mark them up when they're awkward and you have to do it from a ladder. That's it. I think by the end of the day, we'll have at least a couple more of these trusses up, fingers crossed. And then, within a week, the whole thing should be set and we'll be just doing wall boards. And that'll be a huge step forward, because even before we put a metal roof on top, if we have wall boards, we can get a tarp on top and the tarp will at least start shedding water and start keeping it a little bit less of a total rain environment in here when it rains. That's it. Thanks for watching.